Now, Anne Sophie von Otter is one of the great names among her generation of opera singers. Her voice, they say, is like Nordic silver. She's best known for her trouser roles, the parts like Octavian in Der Rosenkavalier, Cherubino in The Marriage of Figaro, and Sesto in Handel's Julius Caesar. Well, tomorrow Anne-Sophie will be at the Barbican in London playing another of Handel's heroes in a concert performance of Xerxes, and she joins us from Broadcasting House in London. Anne-Sophie, why do you wear the trousers on stage so often?
Well, I wish I didn't have to, but it's the fate of the mezzo-soprano voice. There aren't that many roles for me to wear a skirt, but there are plenty wearing trousers, as you said, from Mozart or from earlier still, right up until Richard Strauss, the Rosenkavalier. And, well, in Handel's days, these roles would have been sung by a castrato, a snipped man who kept his light, high voice, even as an adult. And Richard Strauss, well, he wanted the person to sound very young, and he couldn't have a young boy sing it. He chose to have a woman singing this role. So there are lots of them, and I've always done them, and I'm really, really used to it, and it's no big deal.
Now Xerxes is not one of the more familiar of these characters. What sort of man is he?
Well, he's a Persian king, and used to getting his own way, and he's fallen in love with the fiancée of his brother, sadly enough. And so it's an opera about power and jealousy struggle. And in the end, the brother gets the girl, and Xerxes gets the girl he was meant to marry. So it all sort of ends the way it should.
Now, the Barbican is a concert performance. I know earlier this week you were in Paris in a full stage version of the opera. How much harder is it to perform without the set, the costume, the props?
Well, in a way, it's not easier exactly, but it's different. But it's also a lot of fun doing opera in concert version. I think we, all of us who do it, the singers and the conductor, we all always have a wonderful time, because somehow you let loose in another way, and it's exciting to see what's going to happen. It usually works really, really well, and the audience somehow also seems to think it's great, because they can get pictures of their own inside their heads, or they can concentrate on the music or whatever they fancy, and nothing gets in the way.
Now, last year you did get into a skirt singing Carmen at Glyndebourne. How difficult was it for you, known as this sort of Nordic beauty, to become this Latin beauty?
So the Nordic cool to the Latin slut. Well,
you said it.
Yes. Well, you know, it's Carmen is so different from these trouser roles, because Carmen is a real person, whereas the trouser role boys are fairy tale princes. Most of them don't have, as I see it, there's nothing about real people in them, whereas Carmen could be a person alive today. And to play her at my age was fantastic, because, you know, with the having lived for a while and gone through different things in my life, it was just what I was wanting to do, and it was fantastic. And I have so many good memories of this. I can't remember what your question was now, sorry.
Let's move on, because as your career goes on, it seems to me you do more and more diversification. You did the Beach Boys and ABBA songs with Elvis Costello, and there's a new CD with your accompanist Bengt Forsberg. There's a Swedish track, which we're going to hear. It translates into "So Takes My Heart."
Time it yours.
And Sophie, Watercolours is the second CD of yours of Swedish songs. What's special for you about the Swedish repertoire?
Well, firstly, there are so many really, really good songs. They are, it's lovely to sing them. They're very well written for the voice and the piano. And of course, singing in one's own mother tongue, one's own language, is always a wonderful thing. Well, I hugely enjoy singing in other languages as well, but Swedish is special to me, and I happen to be a great fan of Sweden. I think Sweden is so beautiful, the countryside and the seasons and the... I get all moved when I talk about Sweden, and singing these texts, which are written at the, most of them anyway, turn of the last century, they're very moving for me and sort of easy to identify with, and I just love them.
You were at home a couple of months ago, though, for a rather sad occasion to sing at the funeral of Anna Lindh, the foreign minister who was murdered. How significant is her loss to women in your country?
Well, it was for everyone, not only women. Well, I mean, of course, women with children, and every woman could feel great loss and great. I mean, it was terrible thing. But of course, if you're a mother, you can. I myself have two sons, slightly older than Anna Lindh's sons, and that was what I think a lot of people thought about, the fact that she really tried to be a good mother as well as a full-time politician, and she was such an admired politician as well. I mean, it was really, really, really awful. But the whole of Sweden was in shock. It wasn't just women. Everyone was. Took this, so it was horrible.
Well, Anne Sophie von Otter, thank you very much indeed for joining us this morning.